HTTP headers, there are certain standard ones that you really have to use, host, content type, accept, that kind of stuff. But it's sometimes useful to use HTTP headers to return information, either to provide context into a server or return information about what happened back to a client. Again, I would suggest that you don't use this for actual data, but metadata or information to accompany something or the status of something. That's really what the intention of headers is used for. And the example I like to use is if I'm returning a collection of something, I find it useful to return how many are in the collection so that you know how many you're dealing with before you go and parse everything and so on. So the example I'm going to use is to return a matching results header. Whenever we're returning a collection of something, let's tell the client how many we're returning. So that's basically what we're going to do. We'll do our custom method, actually. So what we're going to do is we are going to replace the code in our custom method. So here we're doing an mReturn request.create response, status code OK, and returning results. I'm just going to change that line of code a little bit. In fact, I'm going to replace it with that piece of code. And basically all I'm doing is I'm grabbing the response, not just mReturning it, and then I'm saying response.headers.add, matching results, results.count.toString. Simple example of implementing a custom response header that's going to provide some kind of useful information to the client that's calling the method. Okay, so let's do that. Let's do a build. While it's doing that, let's go into Postman, into Employee Controller, and let's set up a test for born before / 1970. Let's just send it and see what happens. So it's building in the background because we just did a rebuild, and there's our data. And date of birth 1967, 1968, looks like it's working. And if we look at our response headers, we were getting 9, we're now getting 10, and one of them is matching results 173. Simple as that. Of course, implementing custom request headers is simply a matter of sending the request header in, and then if you're expecting it in an operation, writing some code that looks at context.headers.whatever and go and examine the headers collection and go looking for the header that you're expecting to be there. So there's nothing that lets you on the server declare that you must provide me with a header. You can just throw a bad request error if a certain header is not there, and then in the documentation document that you must provide this header with this type of value, but there's no way you can actually declare that and validate that it happens.